Good afternoon, students. Welcome back to the Rotary channel. We are back with our fourth chapter, that is Physical Education and Sports for CWSN. CWSN stands for Children with Special Needs. In this chapter, we are going to deal with five subpoints in which we are going to study aims and objectives of adaptive physical education, organization, promoting adaptive sports, Special Olympic Bharat, Paralympics, Deaf Olympics, then concept of inclusion, its need and implementation. And lastly, we are going to study about the roles of various professionals for children with special needs, in which we are going to study counselor, occupational therapist, physiotherapist, physical education teachers, speech therapist and special educators. Children with various types of disabilities such as mental retardation, deafness or other hearing impairment, speech or language impairment, blindness, orthopedic impairment that is related to the bones, autism, traumatic brain injury, poor body mechanism, health impairment and so on, have the right to develop their abilities in a democratic society through the process of education. But usually it is seen that they have limited opportunities. So it has become the duty of all the schools to provide them with such an opportunity so that they develop their abilities. For the above mentioned impairment, special education or related services are required. Such children are unable to undertake activities that are performed by the normal children. So in addition to the regular programs of physical education, the special designed programs are given to such children. The school must provide special physical education programs for such children who are unable to receive benefits from regular physical education programs. In 1947, America Association of Health, Physical Education and Recreation, that is AAHPER, conducted a survey to determine the most acceptable term for the identification of physical education for differentially abled children. Consequently, the term adapted physical education was the most acceptable. Since then, this term became popular. Now, adapted or adaptive physical education is a sub-discipline of physical education. It is an individualized program developed for students who require a special design program of physical education. The program of adapted or adaptive physical education involves physical fitness, fundamental motor skills and patterns, aquatic skills, dance skills, individual and group games, and sports. So now we are going to study about the meaning of adapted or adaptive physical education. It can be defined as a diversified program or developmental activities, games, sports, and rhythmic suited to the insert capacity and limitations of the students with disabilities, who may not safely or successfully engage in unrestricted participation in the general physical education program. Adaptive physical education is the physical education which has been adapted or changed so that it may be appropriate for the differentially abled person, as it is for a person without disability. In simple words, it can be stated that adapted physical education is basically a specially designed physical education program for differentially abled students. Whereas adapted physical education provides safe, personally satisfying and successful experiences of physical activity to children who are differentially abled. In fact, it is a direct service, not a related service. It can be applied for infants and even toddlers who need early intervention services. Because of developmental delays in physical, cognitive, communication, social and emotional aspects, adapted physical education is not only for differentially abled infants and students, but also for the people of all ages. The next point is aims and objectives of adaptive physical education. Aims of adaptive physical education or adaptive physical education is to help or aid differently abled students to achieve physical, mental, emotional and social growth proportionate to their potential through special planned programs or regular physical education and recreational activities. In fact, its aim is to provide equal opportunities to the differentially abled students to participate in physical education programs safely and successfully in a least restrictive environment. So, the objectives of adaptive physical education, in which first we are going to study about ensure services to meet special needs. The main as well as foremost objective of the adaptive or adapted physical education is to ensure that a differentially able student is provided with physical education services that meet his or her unique or special needs appropriately. The second one is to enhance self-esteem and self-image. To enhance self-esteem and self-image of the student who are differentially abled is another important objective of adaptive physical education. In fact, all the students can do activities according to the abilities. Set goal for students, for example, to throw a ball 25 times. If they perform it easily after a certain period of time, their goal can be set higher. If the goals set are realistic, then the students can achieve them by working on their motor skills, thus increasing their self-esteem and self-image. Whereas the third one is to develop their own motor skills. The another significant objective of adaptive physical education is to develop their motor skills. With disabilities, motor skills are essential for performing not only specific tasks but daily routine activities also. These skills enable physical disabled students to become active and agile. The next objective is to develop knowledge of good mechanics. To develop knowledge of a good body mechanics is another important objective of adaptive physical education. In fact, adaptive physical education helps each individual to develop knowledge and sense of appreciation with regards to the good body mechanism. The next one is to ensure participation of students in physical education programs. The another important objective of adaptive physical education, that is to ensure that each student active participation in physical education programs regularly at his or her own level, and that the student is integrated into the regular education program whenever possible. The last one is motivate students to protect themselves. The next important objective is to protect themselves under any conditions that may be aggravated through certain physical activities. The next point is organization promoting adaptive sports, especially Olympics, Bharat, Paralympics and Deaf Olympics. So what is Special Olympic Bharat? Special Olympic Bharat is an officially recognized program of Specific Olympic International, which was started by Eunice Kennedy Shriver, sister of John F. Kennedy, the former president of USA. In fact, she believed that with equal opportunities and experience as in anyone else, people with intellectual disability could compete for more than ever, though possible. She was convinced that children with intellectual disabilities could be exceptional athletes, and that through sports they can realize their potential for growth and development. Special Olympic Bharat is a movement that uses sports as a catalyst to change the lives of children and adults with intellectual disabilities or mental challenged persons. It was founded in 1987 as Special Olympics India and changed to Special Olympic Bharat in 2001. It is recognized by the Government of India as a national sports federation for the development of sports opportunity for the people with intellectual disabilities. The Special Olympic Bharat program has so far drawn a number of coaches to work with 850,875 athletes across the country. So now we will study actual mission of Olympic Bharat. Its mission is to provide sports training and organize sports competitions throughout the year for children and adults with intellectual disabilities, giving them persistent opportunities to develop physical fitness, demonstrate courage, experience joy, and to participate in sharing of gifts, skills, and friendship with their families, other Special Olympic athletes, and the community. So now, what is the vision? It is a movement which improves the lives of people with intellectual disabilities, and in turn, the lives of everyone. The touch, through sports training and sports competitions. It empowers people with intellectual disabilities to realize the full potential and develop their skills throughout intense sports training and competition. Consequently, the athletes, sportsperson with intellectual disabilities become fulfilled and productive members of their families and the communities in which they live. In fact, it is an experience that energizes healthily, skillfully, and joyfully. It comprises passionate, determined, as well as committed persons from every walk of life who really knows the value of unique gift of the people with intellectual disabilities. They share common belief in dignity, equality, and opportunities for all people. Oath. What is actually oath is? Let me win, but if I cannot win, let me be brave in the attempt. So now what actually the goals are? Its goal is to provide chance to differentiately able people to develop physical fitness and focus on their holistic development. So what are the achievements? Special Olympic Bharat has been organizing national games in various disciplines since 2002. It has organized various tournaments and championships such as national games, national floor hockey championship, national football and table tennis championship, national volleyball and basketball championship, and national badminton championship. A total of 885 athletes have been participated in the 8 World Summer Games and 5 World Winter Games between 1987 and 2015. Its athletes have won 359 gold, 353 silver, and 423 bronze medals in these games. Approximately 383 Indian athletes have participated in Special Olympic Regional Asian Pacific Games. Competitions are organized at a local, district, state, national, and international level. So what are the benefits? It improves physical fitness and motor skills, instills greater self-confidence and a more positive self-image, forges friendship, and ensures increased family support. It helps in building leadership, promoting health of athletes, and building communities. In fact, it helps in strengthening athletes mentally, physically, socially, and emotionally. So this was all about Olympic Bharat. Paralympic Games. Paralympic Games are a major international multi-sports events for the athletes with various disabilities, such as athletes with mobility, disability, amputations, blindness, and cerebral palsy. Paralympic Games are held at an interval of every 4 years following the Olympic Games. These games are governed by the International Paralympic Committee. The first Paralympic Games were held in Rome in 1960. However, the Paralympic World was used officially in 1988. Summer Olympic Games, which were held in Seoul. This were Summer Paralympic Games. The first Winter Paralympic Games were held in 1976 in Sweden. The Winter Olympic Games were also held after every 4 years. So how is the opening ceremony? The opening ceremony begins with the hoisting of flag and rendition of its national anthem. After the national anthem, the athletes come for a march pass into the stadium grouped according to their nations. All the nations enter the stadium alphabetically according to the host country chooses the language. However, the host country athletes enter the stadium last into the stadium. After the host nation presents its culture in the form of music, dance and singing, formal opening of the game is announced. At the last, Paralympic torch is brought into the stadium and passed until it reaches to the final torch bearer, who finally lights the Paralympic flame. The last one is the closing ceremony. After the closing, that is the conclusion of all the sports event, the closing ceremony begins. Flag bearers from each participating country enters the stadium followed by the athletes who entered together without any national distinction. The Paralympic flag is taken down, the games are officially closed, and the Paralympic flame is extinguished. Now we'll study about International Paralympic Committee. It is a global governing body of the Paralympic movement. The International Paralympic Committee organizes the Summer and Winter Paralympic Games. It also serves as the International Federation for 9 sports, for which it supervises and coordinates the World Championship and other competitions. Its vision is to enable Paralympic athletes to achieve sporting excellence and inspires and excites the world. It was established on 22nd September 1989. Its headquarters is in Bonn, Germany. Its main aim is to develop sports opportunities for all the people with an impairment from the beginners to the elite level. Now, what are the categories of disability? The International Paralympic Committee has established 10 disability categories, including physical, visual, and intellectual impairment. Athletes with one of the disability can participate in the Paralympic Games through not every sport can allow for every disability category. Physical impairment or disability includes impairment muscle power, impairment passive range of movements, loss of limbs, leg length difference, short stride, etc. Visual impairment includes impairment of one or more component of visual system. Intellectual disability includes the significant impairment of intellectual functioning. The International Paralympic Committee mainly serves athletes with physical and visual disability, whereas intellectual disability has been added to some Paralympic Games. Now we'll study about Deaf Olympics. Earlier, the Deaf Olympics used to be called as World Games for the Deaf. The Deaf Olympics are an internationally Olympics committee sanction every event in which deaf athletes compete at an elite level. In Deaf Olympics, the starter's gun, bullhorn, commands or referee's whistles are not used as they cannot be seen in the Olympics. The Paralympics and the Special Olympic flags or any visual signals are used to alert the participants. These games have been organized by the International Committee of Sports for the Deaf since the first event. The Deaf Olympics are more than just the world's second oldest multiple sports after Olympics. These games are the world's fastest growing sports event. Deaf Olympics are held once in 4 years. The first game held was in Paris, France in 1924, where also the first ever international sporting event for athletes with disability. Since 1924, these games have been held persistently after every 4 years. However, these games were not held twice due to the World War II. Deaf Olympic Winter Games started in 1949. In 1924, in Paris, only 148 athletes from 9 European countries participated in this event. From 1924 to 1965, these games were officially called the International Games for the Deaf. And sometimes these games were also called as International Silent Games. From 1966 to 1999, they were called the World Games for Deaf. Occasionally, these were also referred to as the World Silent Games. Since 2001, the games are known as Deaf Olympics. The motto of Deaf Olympics is equality through sports. Till now, the Deaf Olympics have been hosted by 36 countries, that is 36 cities in 21 countries. The main purpose of Deaf Olympics is to provide opportunities to the person with hearing disability to participate in elite sports. The athletes who have a hearing loss of at least 55 decibels in their better ear are allowed to participate in Deaf Olympics. Hearing aid, cochlears, implants, etc. are not allowed to be used in the competition. The various sports in summer Deaf Olympics are athletics, badminton, basketball, beach volleyball, bowling, cycling, road, football, handball, judo, karate, shooting, swimming, table tennis, taekwondo, tennis, volleyball, water polo, wrestling, and wrestling Greco-Roman. Now we are going to study about the concept of inclusion, its need, and implementation. Concept of inclusion. The term inclusion is used in the field of education, that is why it is called as inclusive education. In fact, it is an approach to educate both normal and students with disabilities or with special educational needs together. Inclusive education means normal students and special needs students learn while sharing the same physical space and interacting social and academically. It can be stated that in the education, differently able children are educated with normal children within the same roof. It brings all the students together in one classroom and community. In inclusive education, students with special needs spend most of their time with non-special needs students. Inclusion completely rejects the use of specific schools or classrooms to separate students with disabilities from the students without disabilities. What is the need of inclusive education? Inclusive education provides perfect training of real life. All students with or without disabilities learn to interact and work collectively. Indeed, in India, there is a dire need as well as important of inclusive education. The need of an important and inclusive education are, first one is for special esteem, self-esteem. Each and every individual has self-esteem. Generally, it may be seen that differently abled individuals are less stronger. Research studies conducted in this field indicates that after inclusion in a regular school, the students with disabilities have shown improvement in self-confidence. They display qualities of self-efficiency. They develop confidence in their abilities to interact with one another and society in which they live. The next point is for better social skills and communication. Inclusive education provides ample opportunities to have better social relations among the students with disabilities and without disabilities. As a matter of fact, social skills are learned properly through observation and imitation. Students with disabilities get a better understanding of the world around them. They feel exhilarated about being part of the regular community. A number of cases studied shown that children with autism demonstrate changes in their social behavior while being with the other children without disabilities. Their communication skills are improved a lot. The next point is greater sensitivity. It is usually observed that students without disabilities become more sensitive by learning along with the students with special needs. They understand how words can hurt. They practice patience and learn empathy. The next point is for better understanding of strength and weakness. Students with or without special needs is inclusive schools learns that each and every individual has strength as well as weakness. They learn to appreciate this difference. The next point is higher academic achievement. Inclusive education is beneficial for the students with special needs because research studies conducted in the field shows that the students have done academically well than in inclusive education. Implementation of inclusive education in India. In India, the number of children with disabilities or special needs is really large. They have a number of problems in getting education, especially inclusive education. Now, it is important that inclusive education is imparted in India so that the benefits are enjoyed by all individuals. Government of India should emphasize on the measures for effective implementation of inclusive education, in which the first one is the right of education is to be made effective in all stages so that every child receives education and through inclusion. Addressing children with special needs is also taken care of. Teachers, especially in rural areas, are to be trained well so that they are equipped with the required knowledge to teach children with special needs in an inclusive system of education. Workshops to be conducted to keep them abreast of the recent development in inclusive education. Regular analysis of schools, curriculum, and amenities are to be done to develop a support team to give access to the regular curriculum methods to the children with difficulties in learning. This is possible with flexible approach whereby teachers and the students are able to rectify the problems that they are facing during the teaching learning process. The next point is parents should be taken a resource and be involved in the decision making process to enhance the children's learning. They are to be made partners in the education so that a collaboration efforts would result in effective inclusion education. The next one is for proper implementation of inclusive education in schools. The differently abled students should be treated equally as normal students. In fact, the differentially abled students should be looked sympathetically. They should be recognized by their talents, capabilities, and abilities. The next one is a suitable examination system and a periodic evaluation of the children with the special needs to be in a place to meet the challenges and challenging trends in the special education. Curriculum experts should carefully design programs so that the curriculum is made parallel for all the children with or without special needs in inclusive education. Sincere efforts should be made to develop good relations between the families of the students with disabilities and without disabilities. In this way, both type of students, that is with or without disabilities, will also develop good relationship among themselves. It will be helpful in creating an appropriate environment for implementing inclusive education. The last point is for proper implementation and inclusive education, students related materials like uniform, books, stationery, transport, allowances for girls, boarding and lodging facilities, therapeutic services, teaching and learning material, assistive devices, etc. should be made provided to the students with special needs by the school. A school should form a support team to develop strategies for whole school to meet the requirements of students with special educational needs. In conclusion, it can be said that the government as well as the school teachers should lay due stress on the above mentioned measures for effective implementations of inclusive education. The last point that we are going to study is role of various professionals for children with special needs. That is, in which we are going to study counselor, occupational therapist, physiotherapist, physical education teachers, speech therapist, and special educators. The role of various professionals such as school counselor, occupational therapist, physiotherapist, etc. for the children with special needs is really vital. They help to support such children in achieving their full potential, improving their motor skills, giving abilities to communicate properly, and in promoting the mental as well as physical health. The detail of the role of various professionals for children with special needs is stated. The first one is school counselor. School counselor is the specialist who works with students with special needs in the school. A school counselor is a member of the education team. He also carries out development programs related to the stress management, anger management, conflict management, and positive thinking. He helps all the students, including students with special needs, to achieve their full potential, gain self-confidence, and to become productive members of the society. He also refers students and their families to communicate resources for special assistance. The next one is physiotherapist. So what is physiotherapist? A physiotherapist is concerned with gross motor skills and mobility of the children with special needs. The role of physiotherapist is to assess, manage the children and young persons with the movement disorders or disabilities. The aim of a physiotherapist is to help the children with special needs to their full potential through providing physical intervention, advice, and support. A physiotherapist concentrates in particular on problems that affects muscles, bones, circulation of blood, and lungs. He evaluates movements and functions of the body of children with special needs, with particular attention to physical mobility, balanced postures, fatigue, and pain. Physiotherapists use a range of techniques including massage, manipulation, exercises and movements, electrotherapy, and hydrotherapy. The third one is occupational therapist. An occupational therapist helps children with special needs in performing self-care, skills like eating, dressing, bathing, grooming, that is, activities related to the fine motor skills. He also helps children in participating and interacting with others in play. He helps children in adaptive to regular schools. He may suggest aid for writing and other classroom activities to help their them to participate equally with the other children. He also works on hand-eye coordination to improve skills such as hitting a ball or copying from a blackboard. The fourth one is physical education teachers. Physical education teachers need to determine the abilities of the students with special needs. They also need to determine measures to be implemented to support their participation in sports and fitness. Physical education teachers help in students with special needs to improve their physical fitness. Physical education teachers also provide such physical activities for students with special needs, which may help in reducing anxiety, stress, tension, and depression. They organize various physical activities for the students with special needs in order to promote their mental and physical health. The fifth one is speech therapist. A speech therapist in the school provides treatment, support, and care of the students with special needs who have difficulties in communication. Speech therapists help students with special needs to gain ability to communicate through speech and language. Speech therapist helps to provide training for those students who face difficulty in producing sound or saying words incorrectly. They also help such students who have fluency disorders like stoppages, reception, repetition, or prolonging sounds in words. And the last one is special educator. A special educator or educational teacher often has students with varying learning, mental, physical, and emotional abilities. They may assist students with special needs in the areas of physical skills, learning through play, communication, improving social and emotional skills. Indeed, special educator's main responsibility is to assess their students' cognitive abilities. They also create and apply and activities to meet the requirement of the students with special needs. So this was all about the chapter 4th. That is physical education and sports for CWSN. I hope you all must have understood the 4 points. So I'll be joining you back again for the 5th chapter. Till then, take care. Have a nice weekend.